first quarter, no question about that. Bill Hazen back with you here courtside. Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds and allow our stations to identify themselves. You're listening to the D-League tonight. We return to action, and Ryan Whitman starts things off in the second quarter with a three ball just above the top of the key, slightly to the right, and that makes it a three-point ball game. That takes care of three of the six right there. Ryan Whitman, who came in as the number two three-point shooter in the D-League at 45-9. And man, has B been on a hot streak. Feet under the basket, Agunye up and under on a great feed from Chris McCray, and Agunye has on the board with his first 2 points. Going to check, I was expecting Keaton Grant in there, and indeed he is in there. Chisholm with a jump shot from the right wing, he didn't get it. Rebound to Chris McCray. It has been end-to-end, a very high-speed game early. Feet inside, Agunye the target, was he fouled? Foul called Anthony Kent, who also just came in. Team's first, the product of Ball State, the very likable product of Ball State, I might add, who is finishing out his third year with the Mad Ants. First foul shot is good for Agunye. He has three now. And all of the points for Sioux Falls this quarter. Puts it in, he has four, 35-28. We have had a 15-point swing in this game. Whitman, a three ball, got it on the feet from Raviel. Boy, I'll tell you one thing, you cannot let Whitman set up like that, because that's a 50% shot or more with him doing the shooting. Hand off to Keaton Grant, a long top of the jump shot, rattled it in, nice move. Keaton Grant got loose in there, also a product of Purdue. And Grant has two. Here is Whitman for another three, didn't get it. Kent tried to keep it alive, tipped it into the hands of Ron Howard. Mad Ants will reload, trailing by six. On the baseline, Chisholm with a run over the middle, short on a hook shot, tipped out of bounds. Hit Anthony Kent out of bounds. The ball goes over. And it will be Sioux Falls getting it back. If you heard the word blue, blue, that was the voice of Mo McCone, the head coach of the Skyforce. Our broadcast position is near the visiting bench. It's always been that way. It facilitates some of the wiring here. McCray in the lane tried to go up. Kent blocked his shot. Chisholm has it. Mad Ants on a run out. Deflected into the hands of Ron Howard behind the back. Too hot for Anthony Kent to handle. He went behind the back with a feed. Kent was actually looking for a shot. Turn around at the last second, the ball was right on him. 37-31. Here is a lob play. Agunye under the basket and down she goes with a rim wrecker. Agunye with a 6-point quarter. And there's going to be a timeout taken. It's a 20. We will go ahead and hold it right here. And we'll remind you, with that last dunk, we could call that one a Glenbrook Charger Ram dunk. And if you want to check out the Dodge Ram, Glenbrook Dodge is the place to do it. Or Stephen McDowell came in to begin the second quarter. I think we now have everybody. Stephen wears number 18. Keaton Grant number 17. We also... let's see, there's McDowell, indeed, is defending Whitman. Ravio with the ball. He's covered by Grant. Ravio flips it to Anthony Kent. One dribble, up she goes. Oh, and swishy knocked the bottom out, and he had Agunye right in his face. Anthony Kent cuts it to a 6-point. Sioux Falls lead at 39-33. McDowell to Grant. Fox backs up. Agunye, left wing side. Hand back to McDowell, scissoring to the right hand, ran into his own man. And a jump ball call with Wayne Chisholm. I think he actually ran right into Agunye, who was trying to backpedal but couldn't get out of the way. The McDowell moved so quickly that he kind of ran into Agunye. Agunye was trying to step back, but he just couldn't step back fast enough. Dominique Scales will come in. So now everybody available for duty has played for Sioux Falls. They're going to have to rotate a lot of people tonight. They have only eight without David Bailey. Right now they're playing with a nine-man roster. Ravio, a long jumper, shot it over the top tip into the hands of Keaton Grant. He runs it up quickly. Feed to the far wing side to McCray at three-point range. Looks for a screen from Agunye. Goes the opposite way, fed to Agunye, stolen by Anthony Kent. Allman on the drive. He just came in, tried to put it up, and he drew a foul from Keaton Grant. His first, team's first, and that will put Corey Allman on the line, and now all nine Madans players available are in the game. Rod Wilmot, we understand, is not available tonight. Corey Allman, the first shot is good. You have a lot of three-point shooting power on this Mad Ants roster right now out there. Allman's an outstanding shot. Ryan Whitman, maybe as good of a three-point shooter as you're going to find. Plus, he's tall, so he has an advantage in terms of being able to get that shot off. Corey Allman, we've seen Corey Allman light up some teams. He had 7 three-pointers against Texas earlier in the year, you may remember. He hits both foul shots, the lead at 4 for Sioux Falls. Sean Marshall to the left hand, penetrates, drops it off to McCray under heavy traffic, went up, pump fake, and he drew the foul, and I'm pretty sure it was Wayne Chisholm. Wayne Chisholm. Got it? And for Chisholm, that is number one on him, and the team's second. That'll put McCray on the line. He drops in the first one. McCray is one of those very smooth and savvy type players. He really settles the team down out there. He does a lot of things very well. He picks up Allman now in the forecourt, and Corey has the ball. Far wing side, lobs it to Chisholm. They swing it near side to Derek Ravio. Down on the block to Anthony Kent. Kent over the middle, squares up, jump hook, scores it. Anthony Kent, that time they got him right where they wanted him, and Anthony Kent put it in, and it's a four-point lead again. These teams are trading baskets. McDowell for Sioux Falls. Out front it goes. Marshall tried to lob it in for McCray. Was he held? He may have been. They gave the foul to Corey Allman. That was a hold. And Allman has his first and the team's third. Chisholm and Kent are out. Lazar and Phillips back in. Dominique Scales in has yet to touch the ball. McCray will toss it in. Let's see if Scales steps out. He puts a down screen instead. They get it to Keaton Grant. Stop and go move. Foul line jumper. Back rim on it. Bounces to the right, and Lazar is there to claim it. Screened everybody out. Ravio in the forecourt. Chest pass. Ryan Whitman. I knew I'd say Randy once. Here's a shot off the glass. No. Lazar with a rebound up and in. Lazar puts it up and in. He has 8 points. I'll tell you what. When you've been broadcasting in the NBA, you've been around this game for a long time, it is so hard not to say Randy Whitman once. Here's a drive. Nice basket by Sean Marshall. And the foul went to Marshall Phillips. That is his first, team's fourth. Sean Marshall gets the basket. He has 10. Of course, what I'm referring there to is to Randy Whitman, who people in this area remember him from his days at Indiana, former pro basketball player and a very good one. Got a lot of mileage out of what he had. And also a former NBA coach as well. Hope he's watching tonight. Randy, we send you our best. You know we're thinking of you because I accidentally misidentified you as your son, Ryan. Down the middle, Lazar to the glass. He puts it up and in. Lazar has a total of 10, and the Mad Ants close it to 2 at 43-41 Sioux Falls. Sean Marshall between the rings. It goes to McDowell. Marshall gets it back on a drive on Whitman, gets him up in the air, and Whitman got the foul. Whitman bought the fake. He tried to pull his arms back, but he made contact, and I think the contact was in the chest area. Fifth team foul. It turns the bonus on at 6:39. So the Mandans surrender the bonus at 6:39, and that means some foul shooting practice for the Skyforce. Marshall has two. He now has 11. Sean Marshall will try again, and he gets them both. He now has a dozen points. Sean Marshall, 45-41. Sioux Falls by four. Ravio, a high screen from Lazar. He rolls. Ball goes out front to Phillips. High lows it to Lazar off the block on the left side. Fadeaway jumper on the way. Rolls it up and in. There is a great shooter's roll. Darnell Lazar, who has been so consistent and so good for Fort Wayne all year long. Boy, I hope he gets a look upstairs. He has played so well. Ball nearly stolen. Kick to Coleman. Downstairs. Sykes on a mini dunk. Got a seam. Went in. Was going to lay it up. Got there at rim level and said, you know what? I'm open. I'll take it. Three ball. And Corey Almond drops it in. Mad Ants has some three ball shooters out there. That's five. And now it's a one-point game. 47-46. Sioux Falls. Sean Marshall tried to drive on Marshall Phillips, and we'll see. Foul is called on Marshall Phillips, his second, bonus in effect, and we will see shots when we return. But right now, there is a timeout on the floor, and we will pause.